Morning everyone, Carol here. It's Friday the 17th of April and I do hope that you're all keeping well. I just thought I'd share over the next couple of minutes a few things that are going on at the moment, and in particular about the prevalence of COVID and where I think we are, particularly given the government announced yesterday a further 3 weeks of lockdown. So I thought I'd just cover some of that. But first of all, I just want to say that for the first time last night, I experienced the NHS and key worker people going out by their front doors and in their streets to recognise the efforts of the NHS. I'm usually travelling home at that time, so I've missed it. Home a bit earlier yesterday, which was great, and it really was lovely to see people coming out and recognising the efforts of everyone, actually, in the NHS, in the care sector, and in other key and essential services. So my own thanks to you all for whatever you are doing to help. Thank you very much indeed. So I'm just going to give a bit of a sense of where I think we are with the planning and the modelling for COVID-19. So you may know that we were planning originally for a very large peak, and I've got a chart. They're a bit simple, but bear with me. So this is the chart, and weeks along the bottom and numbers of prevalence, so numbers of patients that would have needed hospital care along the side. The reason I'm sharing this is because this is the picture that we were planning on and the government was planning on where there were no social measures at the time. So this is the shape of the graph that would most probably have, well, almost definitely have overwhelmed the NHS. And it was with this that the government then introduced the lockdown and those other measures, and the aim was to push down that the peak of that curve so the NHS wasn't overwhelmed. So this is now what's happened. In terms of what the government are saying has happened is that there's been success really in terms of the lockdown and the impact, and that line there along the bottom is what the government at this stage think the prevalence curve will look like. So you can see it's much flatter, but you can also see it's actually much longer. And so this is helping us to adapt our thinking from one big bang and having to try to cope with an absolute avalanche of demand into something that is there and peaks and troughs a little, but over many more months. So the reason I share this is because we are having to adapt our planning right the way across the UK, but also that we know that this will become a new normal for us until, for example, there's vaccination widely available, and the take-up of that, we would want to be quite high. So we're in this for the long haul, and therefore we're adapting. So we will be just reflecting on that now over the next few days, and the data will keep coming through each week or so, which is the update. So hopefully that's helpful to you to know what's going on. And there are a couple of other areas that I would just want to touch on. One is about testing. So just to remind people that we can do staff testing, and we are doing staff testing, and therefore to contact occupational health if you have symptoms or symptoms in your family where a test may well be required. So there's plenty of advice and guidance on how to do that. The second thing I want to just mention is PPE. We've done a lot of work on managing the flow of PPE through, but please do let us know if you're worried about that or if there are any issues of access to PPE, and we'll have a look at every single concern that is raised. And then finally, just on a sort of bit more notes where in our personal lives. So one of the things that has been noted is that there's an increase in domestic violence, and some of that doesn't discriminate as to whether you're a health worker or not a health worker. And so I did just want to indicate that advice, help, support is available if you're experiencing, or a friend or a colleague is experiencing, domestic abuse, and you can also speak confidentially to occupational health. So as well as national helplines, there's that facility as well. But as we face another 3 weeks of lockdown, I hope that you're coping. Don't forget, I've mentioned before, some silver cloud and other helpful mechanisms to manage this as we move through. So please do use those, and I'll be back in touch again soon. And thank you to everyone for your help in managing this pandemic. Take care. Bye bye.